I'm going to walk through how refunds work between Stripe and NetSuite. There's a bunch of ways to represent payments in NetSuite. You could use a customer payment, a customer deposit, or a cash sale. Similarly, there's a lot of ways to represent refunds. You could use a customer refund against an unapplied customer payment, a cash refund, or a credit memo coupled with a customer refund. What SuiteSync does is try to detect which combination of records you're using and allow you to either issue a refund through Stripe and let us create the correct records in NetSuite, or you can issue a refund in NetSuite and we'll push the corresponding correct refund amount to Stripe. I'll walk through just this diagram here real quickly to give you an idea of how this works and then show you a couple live examples. So for this first example here, a refund is issued through the Stripe API or dashboard. Doesn't matter how the refund is issued in Stripe, just as long as it's issued in that system first. Once we receive the notification from Stripe that a refund has been occurred, which normally happens a couple seconds after it's actually issued in Stripe, we basically check the corresponding charges status in NetSuite to determine what to do. If the charge is applied to a transaction, so if it's a cash sale or if it's a payment applied to an invoice, that sort of thing, then we go ahead and either create a cash refund or create a customer refund and credit memo for the refund. If the charge isn't applied to a transaction, so it's just an unapplied payment in NetSuite, we can create a customer refund directly against that payment to refund it. So this is what's going to occur, this workflow, if you issue a refund in Stripe. Let's walk through what happens if you issue a refund from NetSuite. If you issue a refund from NetSuite, you'll do it in a couple different ways. If the charge is applied to a transaction, so if it's applied to an invoice, you're going to create a credit memo. And then after the credit memo is created, SuiteSync receives a notification that that credit memo has been created and will push the corresponding refund amount to Stripe. After we've refunded the charge in Stripe, we go ahead and create a customer refund and apply it to the credit memo. If the charge is a cash sale, you can just create a cash refund and we will automatically push that refund to Stripe. Or if the charge isn't applied to an invoice or isn't a cash sale, you can just issue a customer refund directly against the unapplied payment in NetSuite, and we will push that corresponding refund amount to Stripe. For any of these workflows, we'll automatically reconcile the customer refunds to the corresponding bank transfer that it's included in. This means that initially, all the refunds are gonna post to your undeposited funds account, and then later on, they're gonna automatically move from that account to your cash account when we've received the notification from Stripe that they've been successfully deposited. Okay, great. Now let's take a look at a couple of examples. First, let's take a look at issuing a refund in Stripe and watching how the corresponding records, in this case, a credit memo and customer refund, are created in NetSuite. The case we have here is an invoice that's been paid in full by a payment from Stripe. Let's take a look at the payment record in NetSuite that's created by SuiteSync. You can see the Stripe charge ID here. This is the charge that we're going to refund in Stripe. In this case, the payment's fully applied to an invoice in NetSuite. So we're going to go ahead and go to the charge in Stripe and then refund the payment, which is going to create a credit memo and customer refund. When the charge is refunded in Stripe, we receive a notification and we'll create the customer refund and credit memo within a couple seconds. Let's go back to the invoice and navigate to the customer transactions to view the credit memo and customer refund. Here's the credit memo that was just created by the integration. You can see here that the credit memo was created from invoice 236000, and if we go back to this invoice that we were looking at before, it's the same invoice number. If we scroll down and take a look at the line items, the original line items on the invoice are used. There's some options available to customize the line items used on the invoice so you can ensure that your credit memos have the correct GL impact. If we take a look at the record that the credit memo is applied to, it's a customer refund. This customer refund is created automatically by the integration, and when it's paid out from Stripe to your bank, essentially when the cash is removed from your balance in Stripe, it's going to be automatically reconciled back to the corresponding bank deposit. So initially it's going to hit your undeposited funds account, and then 2 business days later, depending on how your Stripe account's configured, it's going to be pulled out of your undeposited funds and posted to your cash account. Next, let's look at another example where we're initiating a refund from NetSuite to Stripe. In this case, the invoice is structured exactly the same as the previous example. There's an invoice in NetSuite that's paid off by a charge in Stripe. Here's the payment in NetSuite, and here's the charge ID from Stripe. So let's hop over to Stripe and take a look at the charge. Right now, the charge is not refunded and was just created today. And what we're gonna do is go over to NetSuite and refund the charge here. We're gonna do that by issuing a credit memo. So let's go ahead and create that credit memo. And in this case, we're gonna issue a full refund. Partial refunds are also supported. You could just update the line items on the credit memo to total up to the amount you'd like to refund. And that exact partial refund amount would be issued. In this case, we're just gonna keep it simple and issue a full refund. And initially, this credit memo is gonna remain open here. When we receive the notification from NetSuite that a refund has been issued, we're gonna apply a customer refund to this credit memo. So now that we've created the credit memo, this is gonna issue the notification to SuiteSync to push the refund to Stripe. So let's hop over to that charge in Stripe and refresh the page. You can see here that the refund was issued in Stripe. This payment is now fully refunded. So if we hop over to the credit memo and refresh this page, the credit memo is now fully applied, and if we hop over to the Apply tab, we can see that a customer refund is applied to this credit memo. The customer refund was created by SuiteSync and will initially post your undeposited funds account and later be connected to a bank deposit when Stripe withdraws the funds from your available balance. This is how you would issue a refund in NetSuite for any payments that are applied to an invoice. Next, let's walk through issuing a refund in NetSuite for a payment that's unapplied. Okay, so here in NetSuite, we have a payment that's unapplied, so there's nothing in the apply list, and it's a Stripe charge, meaning it was created by Stripe in your NetSuite account. So let's go ahead and issue a refund for this transaction. Select the customer ID here on the payment. Add it to the customer refund here. Go over to the apply list and select the payment and press save. Now when we've saved the customer refund, that's gonna push a notification to SuiteSync to issue the corresponding refund in Stripe. So let's hop over to the corresponding payment in Stripe. As of now, it's not refunded, but if I refresh the page, the refund is going to be issued in Stripe, and then I'll show you what's updated in NetSuite. You can see that the payment's been fully refunded in Stripe. If I hop back over to the customer refund in NetSuite and refresh the page there, you can see the refund ID has been added to the customer refund, which indicates that we've successfully linked this customer refund in NetSuite with the Stripe refund so that we can handle the automatic reconciliation down the line. In addition to the examples I've shown here, SuiteSync also supports refunding through cash refunds or refunding unapplied payments in NetSuite through the Stripe API or dashboard.